Hey guys, this is Rocking 3, bringing live commentary, Forza 5. And I'm going to try to re-record my audio here. I have it already done. I'm going to check my messages here, get my driver and tuning reward, and see if I got my $1 million because I wanted to buy out my last two cars. And since then, I actually have finished up buying all of the cars. I have 399 cars in my garage, and I have all of them. What this video is actually about is the car pack, the Hot Wheels car pack that came out. I wanted to go through all the different models that came out, and looks like I already own it. Gotta download it real quick, and let's go through them. This first one is very interesting. It is the van. It is the 1983 GMC Vandura G1500. And the reason why this one is important is that this is the A-Team van. So I'm hoping to see some A-Team skins out there and stuff I can download right away. To be honest, I've actually already done that. Another car, 1973 XB Falcon GT. I think this is going to be a really good D-Class car since it's at 364. It's going to be a good muscle car. It has some good numbers, 300 horsepower, 3,000 pounds. I think it'll also probably play pretty well on the C level. So I think that'll be a really good D-Class and C-Class car. Going on to the next one. A little more modern here. We have the 2015 Audi S3 sedan. All-wheel drive. It's already at the top of C. I have a hard time believing this will be a good B-Class car unless you can take it from all-wheel drive to rear-wheel drive. I don't think the all-wheel drives have been real strong in this particular game. We have the Audi Auto Union Type D, 1939. Wow, that is really old. And that's a B501. That might be a good gem there. 485 and 2,800 pounds. That has some pretty good potential of being a really good speed car. Looks like the handling numbers aren't real great on it, but I think if you take that to the top of B or maybe A, maybe it could be an Expo competition car. I'm not sure. Which way is forward on that car? So different. And I stop at that car just because I think there's another car that looks a lot like it. And there we go. We have the Ferrari 375, 1952. Another really old car. Had a B594. That'll be pretty interesting. That could be potentially a pretty good C-Class car. Maybe even A-Class car. Maybe, again, they're trying to get some competition for the Crossbow. But we'll see. This Ford F-100, the 1956, I believe this is probably going to be set up more for a dragster. The handling at 3.2 is pretty low. I think the horsepower starts pretty low as well, but it's at D218, so I think it has the potential of gaining a lot of horsepower with the PI that's left, and if you put, drag tires on it, I don't think it'll hurt it too much either. So I think that's going to be more of a dragster vehicle. Here we go. We got Lamborghini Veneno. This is going to be a really fun car. It's already an all-wheel drive at S800, so it's already pretty high, but the acceleration number 9.3 and speed 7.9, that looks really good. And that's a decent handling number at 5.8 as well. It's a little bit low for an S-Class car, but it looks pretty good. 740 horsepower, 3,200 pounds, that has some pretty serious potential. And I do like the Lamborghinis in this game, so that'll be a fun one to try out. We have another oldie, 1967 Lotus Type 49. That looks like a lowrider. 404 horsepower. Look at the weight on that, 1,500 pounds. That is really seriously light, 1,600 pounds. Good acceleration, 8.9. A little more modern. Looks like kind of a F1 car, number 7 Andretti Autosport. A-Class, though. That seems pretty low for that type of car. Looks like it could be like a Formula 3 car, maybe Formula 4. I'm guessing it's going to look a little bit smaller on the track. That'll be interesting. Look at that front, 35%. That is very rear heavy. All right, moving on to the next one. Toyota Celica GT, 1974, D-Class 211. That is a low number. Handling 3.7, ooh, the horsepower is low at 97, but it's a fairly light car at 2,400 pounds. I think this is a potential good D-class car and maybe a really, really good C-class car. I don't think you could take it up maybe beyond that. We'll see. It looks like this one probably could be a leaderboard fighter, I think, anyway. We'll see how it turns out. Depends on the horsepower combination. If you put the rally engine in that, that thing may be a huge monster. All right, well, that is all the cars. Kind of a unique pack this time with the Hot Wheels track. Definitely some different potentials with these cars. For me, I think I like the Lamborghini, and I think the Audi will be a nice add, and maybe the muscle car as well. So going back to the message center, I'm looking for my gift, my $1 million gift, so I can buy out the rest of my cars. I have two cars left to buy. They're both $1.3 million each. I only have $1.5 million, as you see here. And I'll buy those. I'll get those later. So here we go. We got these two left. We got the Chevrolet number 1, and we have the Honda number 15. I can only buy one of them at this time because I have 1.5 million credits. Waiting for the Forza rewards to come through, that $1 million Forza rewards, so that I can buy them all out. And I'm almost out of skins, so I'm just going to use the regular paint job it comes with. And one car left to go. I have 388 cars in the garage right now. I'm going to get the 10 from the free pack, and then I'll have to get one more for $399. I actually have some duplicates, so I probably should trim some of these down. But I do look forward to trying all the new car pack cars. We'll see how they go. Here's what I'm going to show you. I have one car left, number 15. And of course, it's 1.3 million. So I have a little ways to go, a little bit of work to do there. All right, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Catch you in the next one. Later.